Hello dear friends.
Good morning. Let us see lecture number 10, chapter 13. Last time we already seen some problem based on finding probability distribution. See, two dice are thrown simultaneously. If each denote the number of 6, find the expectation of x. Two dice thrown simultaneously. If x denote the number of 6's, a sample space associated with given random experiment is S is equal to order bell x y. X is running from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let me know. Same thing, what is y? Is also 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Two bells are thrown simultaneously. One by one, we want to toss two bells. So total number of outcomes are n is equal to 36. Now x denote, random variable x denote the number of 6. X from s to r here is x of uv is equal to number of 6's in order pair uv for all uv belongs to S.
Or you can take x values. Because members in S is function of order pair x, so the number of 6's in U. For this one, for this example, first of all, we need to find random experiment as per given question. See, here we want two dice are thrown simultaneously. So, as per given thing, what is the sample space associated with this thing? Is this one. Clear? Now, total number of outcomes are 36. X denotes the number of 6 is entered on base of that. So that is our random variable. What is range search? Range of X is range of random variable X is. See, order pair AB is there. Number of 6's are there. Order pair is there. So both are other than 6. At least one of them is 6. Or at most 2, 6 are there for the pair. So now we need to find probabilities. What is mu of 0? Is nothing but probability of other than 6. How many possibilities are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, cross. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yes or no? Yes. See, in these operations, order pair 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, 1, 5. There is no 6. Same way 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3, 2, 4, 2, 5. Likewise So there is no six. So how many outcomes are there? Total 25 for this year. And total number of observations are 36. Now, P1, at least 1 6 are there. 1 6. 2 6 from the second row. 3 6 from the third row. 4 6 from the fourth row. 5 6 from the fifth row. While last number 8 is 6 1, 6 2, 6 3, 6 4, 6 5. Is it clear? That consists 1 6. See, how many observations are there? 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 and 10. Yes or no? So what is P1? P1 is R by 10 by 36. Next one you want, P12 is nothing but probability of getting 2 6. Yes or no? How many observations are there? Yes. Only one observation. Which one? 6 6. That consists 2 heads. Yes or no? And that is R by 1 by 36. Answer. For probability distribution, what we need to see that some of these 3 probabilities should be 1. 25 plus 10, 35 plus 1, 36. So what is probability distribution? And therefore, probability distribution of random variable X is as follows. Yes, please tell me how many elements in range of X are there? 0, 1, 2. Corresponding probabilities are there for 0. For 0, probability is 25 by 36. 10 by 36 and 1 by 36. What do you want? Find the expectation of X. That means we want E of X. After finding probability distribution, what is E of X? And therefore, expected value of X is nothing but Q of X. One can say mean also, or they can ask find mu also. That is equal to sigma xi Q of xi, that we know. So 0 into P of 0, 1 into P of 1, 2 into P of 2. So this comes out 0, 10 by 36, 2 by 36, that is 12 by 36. So that comes out 1 by 3. That we want. See here, we want if 2 dies are from simultaneously, X denotes the number of 6's. Then find the expectation of X. In this way you can find it.
Okay, let us see next one.
Here. What is it? Here.
Two numbers are selected at random without replacement from first six positive numbers. Clear? X denotes the larger of two numbers. Find x or expectation of x or mean or mu. Clear? Now see here. Let us see what is simple space.
Mm. larger than the 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Larger is
number is either 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6.
This is the range.
Now what we have to find?
Here we have to find probability of all these numbers. So let us see.
See, that is a simple solution, of course.
What is P of 2? In same age, probability having larger 2 from given 2, only one pair is there. 1. That is 1 by 15. Yes, sir. Then, what is P of 3? That means all those observation for this 3 is larger.
1, 3, 2, 3. That is 2 by 15. What is P of 4?
1, 4, 2, 4, 3, 4. Yes, sir.
1, 4, 2, 4, and 3, 4.
How many observations are there? There are 3 observations. 4 is 4 is larger.
So that is 4 by 15.
Then find out what is P of 5. The same is probability P of 5. That is larger number is 1, 5. 1, 5, 2, 5, 3, 5, and then 4, 5.
Sorry, here 3 is there.
Not 4, but
3. Here outcomes are 3, but 1, 2, 3, 4.
So here observations are 4 by 15. What is P of 5, then P of 6? See? P of 6. That is equal to 1, 6, 2, 6, 3, 6. 4, 6 and 5, 6. How many operations are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That is 5 by 15.
5 plus 4, 9. Plus 1, 10. Plus 2, 12. Plus 3, 15. So,
what is probability distribution? And therefore, probability distribution of X is as follows. Where to where? What are the elements in range?
2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
So x is equal to x. P of x is equal to 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6.
P of 2,
1 by 15. P of 3, 2 by 15.
3 by 15.
4 by 15 and 5 by 15.
Actually, what we want? See? We want P of X for X condition. So, what is P of X?
And therefore,
What is ego of x?
X sign into p of x sign. 2 into p of 2. 3 into p of 3. Up to 6 into p of 6. 4 into p of 4. 5 into p of 5. 6 into p of 6. So 1 by 15 is out. Can I take it common? 1 by 15. 2 into 1, 2. 3 into 2, 6. 4 into 3, 12. 5 into 4, 20. 6 into 5, 30. 15. 50. 50 plus 12, 62. Yes or no? 62 plus 8, 70. So,
then EX, EX square, then where
That means although element for which sum is 2, only one pair is there. So 1 by 36. How many elements are there for which sum is 3?
See, 1, 2 and 2. 1,
2 elements are there. 1, 2 and 2, 1. So that is 2 by 36. Now sum is 4. Please tell me, how many operations are there? 1, 3. 3, 1. Any other one? Yes, that is 2. So how many elements are there?
3.
So the probability 3 by 36. Now we know sum is 5. P of 5. What are the elements? 1, 2. Yes? 2, 3. Then 3, 2. Then 4, 1. Only these 4 elements are there. For which sum is 5. So 4 by 36. Now see, P of 6. What are they? So first row 1, 5, 4. Second row 2, 4, 4. Third row, yes, 3, 3. Then 4, 2. And then from 5. How many elements are there? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So how many elements are there? 5. So 5 by 36. Then what is sum? 7. How many operations are there? From the first row, 1, 6, sum is 7. From second row, 2, 5. Then 3, 4. Then 4, 3. Then 5, 2. Then 6, 1. So, how many operations are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, 6 by 36.
See, starting from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Keep this in mind.
Now, P of 8. What are the operations? From first row 1, 6, 7. From second row 2, 6, 6, 8. 3, 5. From the fourth row? Yes. 4, 4. Then 5, 3. Then 6. How many elements are there?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that is 5 by 36.
Then what is P of 9? Sum is 9. What are the elements? From the third row it comes 3, 6, 4, 5. Then 5, 4, sum is 9 and 6, 3, 7. So, here it comes over. How many operations are there? 4. So, 4 by 36.
Is it clear?
Now, what is sum? 10 is there. From the first row, second row, third row, 3, 6 is there. It's not simple. 4, 4, 4, 6. Any element? Yes, 5, 5. Then 6, 4. How many elements are there?
So 3 by 36.
P of 11. P of only 2 elements. 5, 6, and 6, 5. Yes or no? So 2 by 36. Lastly, sum is 12. Only one observation. Which one? 6, 6. So that is 1 by 36.
Clear? So now we can write probability distribution.
And therefore, probability distribution is as follows. Starting from where to where? Starting from x is equal to a 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12.
Okay, up to this thing.
Corresponding probability. P of x is equal to x is starting for 1 by 36, 2 by 36, according to previous sigma. 3 by 36, 4 by 36, 5 by 36, 6 by 36, 5 by 36, 4 by 36, 10. 3 by 36, 2 by 36, and 1 by 36.
So these are the probability distribution that we know. See. See. 1 by 36. Okay. 1 by 36, 2 by 36, 3 by 4 by 5 by 6 by 5 by 4 by 3 by 2 by and 1 by. Okay? So we get this probability distribution. Okay? Now some mechanical work are there.
See here. What is that? We have to see P of x.
What is P of x?
2 P of 2, 3 P of 3, 4 P of 4, 5 P of 5, plus 6 P of 6, 7 P of 7, 8 P of 8, 9 10 P of 10, 11 P of 11, 12 P of 12.
This is our EX.
So that is equal to 1 by 36, 2 into 1, 2, 3 into 2, 6, 4 into 3, 12.
Likewise.
5 into 4, 20, then 30, 42, 40, 9 for the 36, 30, 11, so to the 22, plus 12.
Then calculate it. Clear? So then, what we need to find?
We need to find EX square. That is equal to 2 square P of 2, 3 square P of 3, plus 12 square P of 12. 1 by 36 is that.
See, how we get it? See,
2 square into 2, 4, 9 into 2, 18, 16 into 3, sorry, plus 1, plus 16 into 3, 25 into 4, 36 into 5, 49 into 6, 8, 64 into 5, 81 into 4, 100 into 3, 121 into 2, plus 144. Calculate it simply, here we get some answer. That is equal to, we get some answer. Then, and therefore, variance of x or v of x, what is formula? Ex square minus ex whole square. You evaluate ex square here and ex from here minus some value square, you get some value. Clear? Use calculator. Then, what is standard deviation is equal to square root of Va. So what of may be value here? Take its square. Then you get the answer. Of course, this question is the longest question of this exercise. But they want each and everything. They want mean, they want variance, they want standard deviation. Ultimately, they want variance and standard deviation. But for variance, we need to find mean, we need to find ex square, and according to this formula, we can obtain variance. Then find standard deviation, square root, the positive square root of variance is nothing but standard deviation. Next. What is given? A class has 15 students whose ages are 14. Here, 14, 14, 2 times, 15, only one time. Yes or no? 14, 15, 16, here and here, 2 times, 17, here, here and here, 3 times. 18, only one time. 19, one, two. 20, one, two, three. 21, only one. See? Here, a class of 15 students are 14. 14, how many times?
2 times.
15. Only one.
Error in increasing order of x for age. In a class of 15 students, 2 students are of the age of 14 years old.
One student 15 years old, I think. How many students are 16 years old?
1 and 2. 16 and 15.
17.
1, 2 and 3. 1, 2 and
3. Students are over 17 years old. 18 years.
14, 17 years, there is no 18 years only. One student is there, 18 years old.
19,
1 and 2.
20 years.
Here, and here.
20.
3 students are there. And 21 years old is 1
student. Mata Mata is here.
21. Calculate.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15.
Okay? Suppose, what is the
number? One student is selected in such a manner that each age is the same chance being chosen of age X of the selected student. Is that what? Here, X is a selected student of some age. Yes, for is for her age. That is the word X. Random variable X of U. Now see.
According to this manner, how to write probability distribution?
P of X is equal to 2 students. students are Aman 15 students, that is 2 by 15, that is 1 by 15, 2 by 15, 3 by 15, 2 by 15, 3 by 15, here we, how many numbers are there? So 1 by 15, yes, for our mind. 2 by 15, 3 by 15, 1 by 15. 2 plus 1, 3, 3 plus 2, 5, 5 plus 3, 8, 8 plus 2, 10 plus 1, 11, 13, 14. See, 2 plus 1, 2 plus 2 plus 1, that is 5 plus 3, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 15 by 15. Yes? Now what we want, this is the probability distribution. What do we want? What is the probability distribution arrived? Find mean variance and standard deviation. See? What is Px? Mean is equal to Px. 14 P of 14, 16 P of 16, up to 21 P of 21. So you can replace the value 1 by 15, 14 into 28, 15 into 1, 15, 16 into 2, 32, 17 into 3, 51, 18 into 1, 19 into 2, 20 into 3, plus 21. In this way, you can obtain that. So, using calculator you can find answer. What is Ex square? 14 square P of 14, 15 square P of 15, that we know that formula. 21 square P of 21. In this way you get some value here. What is V of x? Variance of x is equal to E x square minus E x whole square. E x from here you get E x square and here you get E x. Something minus something square, you get the sum value. And what is standard deviation? Sigma x or standard deviation of x is nothing but positive square root of this, then you get the variance. Okay. Now see it. Next. In a meeting, 70% of the members favor and 30 offer the certain proposal. A member is selected at random. We take x is equal to 0 if he opposed. Take x is equal to 1 if he is in favor. Directly, here x is given to us. What is probability distribution? Here, probability distribution. Only two possibilities are there. X
is equal to x. X is equal to 0 if we opposite. X is equal to 1 if we favor. For a certain event. See, 70% of members, that is 7500, is in favor. And 30% are opposite. So 30/100. So point EVS and VA, variance of X. What is U of X? 0 into P of 0 plus 1 into P of 1. So this one comes out 0 and you will get 7/10. So 0.7 is the mean. What we need to find? Variance, that is 0 square into P of 0, 1 square into P of 1, you get some. Sorry, we get EX square, not variance. What we get here? EX square.
Now, as per the previous example, you can find remaining things. Now, see. Mean of the numbers obtaining throwing a die having written 1 or 3 bases.
1 return on how many bases for return? 1 on 3 bases. And 2 on 2 bases. And 5 on 1 bases. What does mean? So first of all, probability distribution. Only 3 possibilities are there. Either integer optimum case is 1, 2 or 5. Corresponding probability P of X is equal to 1. How many cases have it?
3 ones.
So that is 3 by 6. And here 2 by 6. And here 1 by 6. Clear?
So that is this.
What is EX or mean? 1 into P of 1, 2 into P of 2, 3 into P of 3. So 1 by 6 is there. 3 ones are 3, 2 twos are 4, 5 ones are 5. That comes out 12 by 6, that is 2. So option 2 is
there. Directly. Next. That is, suppose two cards are drawn at the random from the deck of cards. Let X be not the ace of A. See.
That means there are X is equal to X. How many cards? 2 cards. There is no X, 1 X or 2 X are there.
0 X means
from 48 cards we have to select 2 cards. From 52 card, we have to select 2 card. That is 0. 1 card is 4C1, 48C1, and 52C2. That is 1 card is X card.
And the other one is 2 cards are X card.
For this one, 4C2. Over 52C2, calculate.
Then look at this one. Then you can find the X is 3. Dear friend, this complete exercise 13.4. Next time we will prepare this, we are going to discuss
only tribes and binomial distribution, and that is the last topic of the exercise. Is it clear to all of you?
Yes.
Thank you. We are going to see next in the next chapter.